In Lesson 5.1, students see a video of water spraying from a fountain, but that the water holds together. Later, they look at the evaporation of water and alcohol and wonder whether these two phenomena are somehow related. The question is, does water evaporate faster or slower than alcohol, and why? The science concepts covered are that water is a polar molecule, that the polarity comes from the unequal sharing of electrons in the covalent bond between the oxygen and the hydrogen atoms. They realize that alcohol is less polar than water, and that less polar alcohol molecules evaporate faster than more polar water molecules. They also work on designing a fair test. So, students have seen water molecules throughout middleschoolchemistry.com. In Chapter 4 in particular, they saw how water forms a covalent bond. We review that in Chapter 5 and show that it's the mutual attraction that brings the hydrogens and the oxygen atom together to form a water molecule. Once you have the water molecule, students realize that it's completely neutral. There's no overall charge in the water molecule, but there is a charge separation. And that's caused by the unequal sharing of electrons. The electrons actually spend more time around the oxygen than they do around the hydrogens, because oxygen has what's called a greater electronegativity. That just means that it attracts electrons in a covalent bond more than the other atom it's bonded to. Let's just see. So that's sometimes depicted by this thing called a charge density model. So the darker area here just shows that electrons spend more time near the oxygen than they do near the hydrogens. And since electrons are negative, this area of the molecule is slightly negative, shown by these negative signs. And this area of the molecule near the hydrogens is slightly positive, since the electrons don't spend as much time there. And this is, the charge density model is often shown as a colored kind of a model, where this part is negative and this part is positive. So students can use this idea of the charge separation or the positive and negative area on polar water molecules to explain some things they've seen about water. Now let's look at it one more time. That it has a strong cohesion, water molecules stick together, that they have a strong surface tension, and students are going to see whether this has anything to do maybe with the rate at which water evaporates. So you want to do a test to see whether water or alcohol evaporates faster. So we ask students to help design the test. So they want to use the same amount of water as alcohol, put it on some surface, in this case a brown paper towel, at the same time and in the same way, and see which one evaporates first. That's a fair test. So students will realize after doing that test that it was the alcohol that evaporated first. So the question is, why? Does this have anything to do with water sticking together? We look at water again, and this is a space-filling model, and you see that water is more polar than alcohol. And that's because the water has positive area near the hydrogens and negative area near the oxygen, but alcohol is a big area that's pretty non-polar at all, just carbons and hydrogens. So alcohol doesn't stick to itself to the same extent as water does. That could explain why alcohol evaporates faster than water. Also, on the student activity sheet, students look at the boiling point difference between water and alcohol and try to explain that in terms of water's polarity and alcohol's somewhat less polarity. And you can explain it. Since water is polar and the molecules are very much attracted to each other, it takes more energy to make them move fast enough in order to reach the boiling point. For alcohol, they're not as attracted to each other, so you need less energy to make them move fast enough to boil. That's shown by the lower temperature that you need to raise alcohol to make it boil. If you're in an NGSS state, there's a performance expectation, MSPS 1-1, which says develop models to describe the atomic composition of simple molecules and extended structures. Lesson 5.1 relates to this performance expectation in that we're using evaporation rate to look at water molecules and alcohol molecules to understand what it is about them that might contribute to this different rate of evaporation. If you look at the foundation boxes, students have developed a model to describe phenomena and they planned and carried out an investigation. For structure and properties of matter, students have seen that substances are made from different types of atoms. They've looked at water and alcohol, and that these have different physical properties in that they evaporate at different rates. And this idea of scale, proportion, and quantity, students have looked at the molecular level explanation, the polarity difference between water and alcohol, to explain a macroscopic phenomena, the different rate of evaporation. So thanks for watching, and good luck with the lesson.